What's cracking, guys? Bruce Mattson here, your host show of Metric Scout Fantasy Football. Right now, today, I'm ranting on Noah Fant. I saw some ridiculousness online yesterday. Been brewing it over, thinking about it, and Twitter's just weird. Twitter is just weird when it comes to fantasy football. It's just this weird market, but it kind of bleeds into leagues, so I'm here to talk about it, and people were talking about Noah Fant, Siffy was pretty much dead. They were just going down the rankings, and everybody was spouting off what tight ends they'd take over him and that. And the thing about it is people are just putting his value in the dirt right now. And that is just sparking some ideas that's going in my head. Am I here to be on a Noah Fant hill right now? Not really. It's a tight end. I don't care about tight ends. But at the same token, if you're going to kill somebody's stock, I might have to take advantage of it. So I want to look into this, see what I want to pay for him in leagues, and see what I want to do to see if we can get Noah Fant on the cheap here, a dirt cheap asset. And there's a lot of reasons for this, and we're going to go over them right now. First thing I have pulled up here is keeptradecut.com, and we're going over those rankings real quick. ADP hasn't rolled out recently, so this is the quickest way to get some value off him. I don't like using the site that much because I don't feel like it's real. But rankings-wise, I feel like it's very comparable to how the market's acting. Looking at his stock portfolio now, it's just trending down. Yesterday, they were beating his dick into the dirt, and today he's valued at around the mid-second round pick. Early, what is up with that? Why is a mid-second round pick? Oh, that's early 2024 second. Late 20, that's so weird. But he's valued around a mid-second round pick in 2022. And the way things were sounding like, the way those dudes were talking, some people said Irv Smith did take over him, Zach Ertz. They've mentioned other guys down the line here, Trey McBride. There's all kinds of craziness going on. And it's not the one-for-one with the tight ends, because once you get down to a certain way on the tight ends, they're all really the same, especially when you're talking about a tight end 1 versus the tight end 15. Like say if you're around tight end 8 to 12 range and you're graded against points per game or your overall success from a week-to-week basis to the tight end 15, there's not much of a difference. So if you can get a prospect that has some upside with them, and you can catch him at a discount and get him on the cheap, that's better than paying up for him. We got a guy here with Noah Fant who we can catch at a discount. And here they got him valued at a mid-second. You're not supposed to screw over your league mates and try to get one over on them. But this might be the opportunity you can do that. He just went to Seattle. A lot of people are not in love with that offense. A lot of people aren't in love with what's going on. But this guy's got some goods in his profile, his prospect profile from when he was coming out of college, come from the combine. And that could still stick. That could still happen. And it's not like we're paying for him. And I'm not paying him mid-second for him. That's not what I'm trying to do. Nah. I'm going to try and get him for a third. I am more than happy to get told no a bunch of times. But if I get that one yes and reel him in for a third, especially when my rookie draft's going, I'm doing it. Because from what I saw yesterday, people were just pounding him. I'm talking about like 10, 15 people on Twitter, maybe even more. And that's just from what I saw. I wasn't even trying to see it. I just looked at it and went on about my day. But it stuck in my head a little bit. And I was moving like, man, people are really hating on Noah Fant right now. And you go to Player Profiler, I suggest giving this site a look if you've never been on here. It's owned by the great Matt Kelly. Good old dude. But right here, you look at the workout metrics here. 98th to 99th percentile on all of them. You're talking about a super athlete. Super athlete. They were making comparisons to guys like Dawson Knox. Dawson Knox was like in the 80th percentile in most of his scores. But that's not in nine. There's a difference to that. There's a difference in an athlete like this that's 250 pounds that's running a 4.5. You just don't see that. You just don't see that. And then you come down to his stats here. They got him listed. Games played 16, 90 targets last year. Bad Broncos team. A Broncos team that wasn't getting it done. 68 catches, 670 yards, four touchdowns, 9.9 yards per game, 9.9 fantasy points per game. 2020, 93 targets, 62 balls caught, 673 yards, 10.9 yards per reception, 3 touchdowns, 10 fantasy points per game. You're getting double digits right there in fantasy points per game in 2020. You want double digits. You don't get double digits hardly at all from your tight ends. Hardly at all from these guys. You're barely getting 12 tight ends in double digits scoring on any given week. There's times where you're only getting like 5 or 6. There's at least 2 or 3 weeks out of the year every season where there's only like 8 or less tight ends that hit double digits. And the rest, like tight end 8, 9, 10, 11, they're like 9 PPR fantasy points, 8. And it goes hilariously downhill from there. 10, that's good. 9.9, that's pretty much 10 right there. That you can't hate on that. And the situation wasn't good there. And I get it. We're going into a bad situation. Injuries have been a plague on Fant. I'm going to tell you that. It's going to be for a lot of players in the league. It's football. It's the NFL. Can't predict injuries. You can't really hold it against players too much. Injury prone isn't really a thing. It kind of is, sort of, but it's really not. First round pick. All this upside here. Just upside. Just oozing it. Sitting in the upside. And we're watching his stock just drop right here. Just collapse. And this stock is going to drop farther throughout the summer. People are going to analyze the situation with the Seattle Seahawks. I mean, let's look at the depth chart. They got the depth charts right up here. Seattle Seahawks. Pull that up real quick. And quarterback play. You got Drew Lock, Jacob Eason, and whoever they draft. You have that. Running backs, maybe Rashad Penny comes back and does his thing. Chris Carson's there. Old Adrian Peterson. And then wide receivers. DK Metcalf could get traded. That could happen any day. Tyler Lockett was on the trade block, or at least talked about through the media. After that, downhill quick. We could be seeing some big changes. This team's talking about rebuilding. Tight end. What's there to compete with here? Noah Fant, Will Disley, Colby Parkinson. They already showed us our hand saying, hey, we want Fant over these guys. They wanted him in that trade. Drew Locke's got some continuity with him. That might be the guy he locks into. The athleticism here between Fant and DK Metcalf. And that's going to be fun to watch. That's going to be fun to watch if Metcalf's still on the team, along with Tyler Lockett. And I get it. This is not going to be a great offense for NFL reasons, but for fantasy, this could be fun. Fantasy, we could be seeing a lot of Drew Lock YOLO balls going in the air. DK Metcalf stretching the field. Tyler Lockett stretching the field. And you know what? Who's going to be running routes over the middle? It's going to be this guy here, Noah Fant. Noah Fant. Am I going to say that he's going to be a tight end one? I don't know. I don't even think it's going to matter if he's like tight end 8, 9, 10 compared to him being tight end 15. That's the thing. But the thing is, here is you're getting a young asset. A young asset who is just 24 years old, hyper-athletic, got a lot of years left in him. This team eventually going to turn things around, get a quarterback. So we'll get more efficient targets, but this team's also going to be in a lot of dogfights where they're going to have to throw the ball a little bit. I know they want to not let their quarterbacks cook, but through attrition, they might have to in fourth quarters anyways. Noah Fant might deliver there. He might be boom bust, but everything's according to price. And what I'm trying to do is get him cheaper than a mid-second, cheaper than a late second. And I want to get him for a third, but also when I'm in the draft, we have to say that from a rookie draft standpoint, this is a dog shit rookie draft. This is a dog shit draft. This is a dog shit year for rookie draft, especially when you get to that second round. Well, dries up, and really we're just speculating on random dudes. What I'm going to say here is once my guys are gone, and I see the speculative assets, and I've still got Noah Fant on the brain, I might put a deal on it. Depends where the pick's at. It could be mid-second. It could be late-second. It could be third. It could be mid-third. I don't know. I'm going to see if I can work out the deal. I'm going to try and get this guy for free. And that's what I'm going to do. And the reason why is not because I value him for that. I value him as a mid-second. I value him as a good speculative asset to have on my team that I want for long-term. It's just everyone was pounding his dick into the dirt, making him a valueless asset, acting like he's dead. And if you're going to act like he's dead and everybody's going to howl off the rooftop saying Noah Fant's dead, but you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to dance while there's blood in the streets and buy up some shares. That's what I'm going to do. And if I can't get it, then that's it. That's real life. That's how the leagues are acting. But it's not Noah Fant versus David Njoku. It's not Noah Fant versus Dawson Knox. It's saying it's Noah Fant versus these guys screaming that he's dead, screaming that his value's over with, and me saying, all right, let's see if I can get him for this value. Let's see if people really hate him going to the Seahawks. Let's see if people really hate him being paired with Drew Lock. Let's see if people really are scared of this ambiguity, because I'm going to buy highly athletic tight ends all day, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then again until my jaw drops, because I'm going to bet on that, especially when it's free. And I'm saying I'm paying for them. I'm not saying I'm buying them. I'm saying I'm getting them for free. That's a difference between buying a player and then getting a player for free. I'm dropping third-round rookie picks, late second-round picks. When the assets are gone, I'm done with my rookie drafts pretty much. And just getting jabronis in the drafts, I might be searching for guys like Noah Fant, see what I can do. That's what I'm looking at. And I may not be getting a lot of deals done, but I'm working the markets, and I'm going to see if I can wring that towel out dry, because that's part of the game, is getting them offers out and getting those surprise offers accepted. And if I can get some Noah Fant on some of my leagues, I'm going to take it. Let's wrap things up. We're buying Noah Fant at the reduced cost, pretty much for free. We're not paying up. We're not paying market value. Noah Fant on board. And we're not saying he's going to be a TE1. We're saying that the profile versus the price is worth the investment, considering what we heard the other day on Twitter going off of people just hammering him down. Just look it up. It was there. I'm not going to spend time pulling the tweets up, but it happened. The one thing I want to hit on before we leave today is make sure you're active in all your leagues. If you hear any chatter of a player being devalued, jump on it. Jump on it. See if you can get them at that reduced price point. See if you can bring them home. Because over time, a trade here, a trade there that you can just capitalize on, you're going to be winning. It's going to make you better. And it may be only like one or two trades like that a year. It could be 5, 6, 7, or none. But more active you are, the more likely you tend to be better in your dynasty leagues. And I have like a decades or so experience on that. But I want to thank you for watching the show, sticking with me. Make sure you hit that subscribe button on the way out. It's right there. And I'll catch ya next time.